Welcome to another Stories from the Stores. Now we're joined today by curator Sarah Bond, and she's told me that both of these objects have been used to detect pregnancy in the last 100 years. Sarah, how is this true?
Both of them are used to detect a hormone in pregnant women's urine called HCG. The scientists first discovered this hormone in the 20s. HCG is really important in preserving the pregnancy in the very early stages before the placenta takes over. And when you introduce most animals to this hormone, they'll ovulate. So the same scientists that discovered HCG found that if you injected it into immature female mice and rabbits, they would start to ovulate and their sexual organs would mature. But they were expensive and they took quite a long time. Just one pregnancy test required 5 separate mice, and all of them had to be dissected at the end of the process. So by the 1930s, scientists were wondering, could you use an animal that didn't need to be dissected? These are a species of Japanese bitterling, a tropical fish, and as you can probably see, they've got quite translucent skins.
Yeah.
So the fish have an organ that they use to produce eggs, and that organ expands in the presence of HCG. And so you can see how this works. This first one here, its organ, which is called an ovipositor, is quite a bit longer than the second one, which is a normal fish. And the last one here has just been dissected to show that organ a little bit more clearly. But essentially that organ would go all the way from about 2 millimetres up to about 25 millimetres.
Was it super accurate?
No, not quite. Unfortunately, that was the sticking point with this test. They weren't very accurate, and even men's urine could often produce a positive result. So just a few years after the fish, a British urologist working in South Africa found that if you injected a particular type of frog with pregnant women's urine, it would spontaneously lay eggs. What's more, it would do so within 12 hours.
So if the animals were so good, why did it take so long to get to this?
Well, in fact, the frog test, as it became known, was used up until the late 60s and early 1970s, and it absolutely was the standard pregnancy test all over the world. And there was a lot of drive to develop a test that women could take in their own homes, just like this one, which is an early home pregnancy test kit. Still detecting exactly the same hormone, it works on a different process, it's a chemical process, so no animals are involved.
So if the frogs took like 12 hours, how long does this take?
The very first chemical pregnancy test took around 2 hours, which was still a vast improvement. And now you can find out the result in a matter of minutes.
So if the animal test was so good, would you still feel comfortable going back to the fish today?
The fish not so much, because they were so unreliable. If the frog test was still around and it was the only option I had, then sure. But at the end of the day, it was so much easier just to be able to walk into a chemist, pick up a test like this, take it home, and then I was the first person to find out that I was pregnant.